That's one of the benefits of being in a shared studio, is you can recruit them to do your stupid things. So our enthusiastic work for the Finger helped us secure a really exciting new client for us, which is Melbourne Fringe. And as well as running their annual Melbourne Fringe Festival every year, the organization is also a year-round artist support network. And so they needed an identity system that could be used for both those things, like the serious corporate stuff, and then much more fun for the festival. And so our solution came in these things, and we call them the Fringe Forms. And they were about this big. And the idea was that you could combine them to make letters. And we then turned that into a whole typeface. You can see here. And then the we made five different logos because they had five different forms. And then completed their corporate stationery by taking some photos of the forms hanging up and then, slapping them on business cards like you do. This is really fun. This is something I found, like a scrapbooking instructional video. This is a self-inking roller stamp that has the forms on it, and you can just roll it out onto anything, like boxes and envelopes, and it worked really well for them. And so now we'd established the corporate ID, we needed to turn up the volume for the festival artwork, and so the aim was to build the word Fringe out of the forms. And so we had them mass produced by a plastic packaging company, and we had a team of volunteers fold them all up together. We needed 500 altogether, and we took it up onto the roof of a building in Bourke Street, and we put all the scaffolding together, and we made a big billboard to spell out the word Fringe. And then the volunteers then installed all the forms one by one. And then the party trick was that we put little tiny keychain LED lights inside each of the forms, so the whole thing would then glow at night. And an awesome coincidence is a friend of ours was doing a photo shoot from the top of the Eureka Tower, and we told him about it, and he actually got a photo of us, like, super zoomed in. You can barely make it out, but there's green, you can see people, and it's definitely us, I promise. And it was, we were really happy with how the final photos came out. We really kind of had no idea how it was going to look till it happened, and it was really quite fun. And we photographed the whole thing from a few different angles, from start to finish. That took about 4 hours, this installation process. And then we used those photos across the whole range of the festival outcomes, including in the program where, as you turn through from left to right through the program, the sign would get more and more built. And we got a free advert in that program. We probably made a few mistakes, such as, just swearing, not saying who we were or that we were the designers. And not putting any contact details in, so we got very few phone calls from this ad. We also collaborated with XYZ Studios on a TV commercial, which is very exciting. We'll show that to you now.
So where are we? 2010, and you can see a theme, new studio. We teamed up with a mate of ours and started our own space on Brunswick Street, Fitzroy. It's in a beautiful old building, which was about an ironmonger's about 100 years ago. And so we renovated ourselves, and I think there's one of these photos, you can see the Finger just tucked up. There we go, little guy.
He lives on.
Our work for the Fringe Festival went really well. We're very happy about 2009, and we were able to work with them again in 2010. And this photo from the previous year had stuck with us and gave us an idea. We wanted to do something bigger, based around the Melbourne CBD. And to show Fringe what we were thinking, we made a little animation. This is the actual video we showed them. And in hindsight, we didn't have to add music to it, so I really apologize for that. But here it is.
We built this city. We built this city on rock and roll. Built this city. We built this city on rock and roll.
Yeah. So, didn't need the music. In case it wasn't clear, we wanted to build the CBD out of wood. So we did it. Went to Bunnings and bought literally a ton of wood, and barely fit in the trailer, but we took it home, cut it up. I'm sure Dad's really pleased that I'm showing his leg to the 6.5 million of you here today. So thanks, Dad. Once again, Fringe comes through with an army of volunteers, and they help us with our build. We built this city on the stage of the Lithuanian Club in North Melbourne, which is one of the main Fringe venues. So much wood. Here's the first of how the images turned out. And then we flipped it around, and that was the reverse side of the program. It's really good being able to work on a festival so large, because you get to work on a variety of outcomes. And it means we can reuse the city, which is a big work for us in a lot of different ways, and programs and reason for signage and QV. And this is the signage from last year that got repurposed in the festival club. And then the other crazy thing was they let us design a tram. Design the outside of a tram. If we designed a tram, we'd have like flames out the back. And so yeah, trams. Despite our best efforts, we got to run another ad. What did we do right this time? Contact details, said who we were. I attempted to Photoshop out my bald spot, but we still swore. But a big improvement.
So the hands-on projects we've shown so far really are just a real small part of what we do in our studio. As well as cutting cardboard and stacking blocks of wood, we also make a lot of websites, which is really how we pay the bills. And we've never really had much overlap between those two sides of our work. And so this year we really tried to explore that. And so here's a couple of self-directed projects we've done so far this year to really try and explore that kind of handmade and the website and put them together. So we've called the first one Cocktail Typer. So we got 100 cocktail umbrellas and installed them on the wall of our studio. In one of the shots, you can see Jono's desk. It's much cleaner than it is in real life. And we turned the whole thing into a website. And the idea is that you can type in short messages and then see them stop motion animated across the screen in the umbrellas.
A little video of it in action. Actually, a little tip, if you find anything I've ever made, try typing snake into it and see what happens. It's a weird fascination of mine. Before we go, we quickly want to go over our most recent project. So Cocktail Typer was really well received online and spurred us on to do another one of these types of projects. But it was fairly low resolution. You could only make a couple of letters at a time. And we decided we wanted to do something with more objects. And for some reason, we thought of dice. And so jumped on eBay, bought 1,000 of them. And this is how we started Dice Painter. And we had this idea that if we used 1,000 dice, we could probably do something more than write text. We could maybe, if we did it right, paint little pictures. And we needed 6 different colors for this, but buying 6,000 dice would have raised some eyebrows at Australia Post. So instead, we positioned 1,000 of them, took a photo, photoshopped the color. Oh, they were all put in a custom-made dice holder. Yeah. Photoshopped the color, rotated all 1,000 dice by hand to the next number, took a photo, repeated, until we had 6 slides. That only took 36 hours straight, which was only 35 hours more than we thought it would take. And then to engage website visitors, we thought if you typed in your Twitter username and then the dice would paint up your Twitter profile picture. It's hard to kind of explain here with my silly words, but if you go online and check it out, you'll see how it works. But here's a little video to try and explain it for now. Thank you.
So before we go, I just wanted to say that if you see us in the audience or afterwards or at the after party tonight, please come talk to us. I know that's hard. I never talked to anybody for 8 years, and I really, really regret that. I miss talking to some really amazing people, and we'd love to hear about you and your work.
So thanks to AGIdeas for having us, and thanks for being a wonderful audience, and just thanks.